Hi guys, so in this video we are going to learn about nested list, description list, inserting images in HTML. This is our chapter 5. Already we have learned in the previous video about what is list, what are the types of list are available. And here in this video, this is like a second part of your chapter 5. Nested list, description list are the two other parts which we left in our previous video, and the other topic which we are going to learn here is inserting images in HTML. Okay, so first we are going to learn about nested list. What is nested list? Nested list is nothing but like list inside another list. Okay, a list under another list. So ordered and unordered, both type of list can have these kind of nested list to form a multi-level list. So list under a list, so that is called a multi-level list. Next, here is an example for nested list. So I'm having a program, for example. So here I'm just giving the title is nested. In here we are going to use both ordered list and unordered list. Okay, so come over here. Under unordered list, I'm having the title is fat soluble vitamins. Okay, so title is vitamins, and under here I have ordered list. So ordered list, inside ordered list I have some type of vitamins, and I'm closing ordered list. Now I'm opening unordered list. Okay, so that is water soluble vitamins, then we have ordered list again. Okay, so this will be displayed as a multi-level list. So heading will be like vitamins, and we have two types of vitamins here. Okay, so first one is fat soluble, the other one is water soluble. Under fat soluble we are going to have these vitamins, and under this water soluble we are going to have these vitamin names. Okay, so now let me show the output of this. Yes, so this is called multi-level list or nested list. List under another list. Okay, so this is the list which is coming under another list. So here vitamin is the title. Under this we have two types of list. So under this, under each one we are going to have separate types of list. Okay, so here this is called a nested list, which will be shown as a multi-level list. Next we are going to see about description list. Description list is nothing but like a term which is coming along with its definition. Okay, suppose if you want to define some set of terms, you can use this description list. Okay, so it is used to present a glossary, a list of terms or other names or value list. Okay, so here we are going to use DL tag. So that is used for description list. And under this, we are going to have two more tags, DT and DD. DT is for definition term, and DD is for definition description. Okay, so let me show an example for this, how we are going to use DL, DT and DD. Now take this. So here I have given the heading as description list. Okay, come over here, DL, because I'm going to use this as a description list. DT, the heading is DNA. So this is my term. So definition term. Okay, next, description definition. Definition for this term. What is DNA? I'm giving the definition for this term. Okay, so this is what description list. So we are going to give a definition for a term. In that case, we are going to use this description list. So this is for DNA and this is for RNA. We are make sure you are closing this DT, because the term is closing over there. And when you are completing, when you are finishing your definition, you have to close this DD tab. So that is the main thing you have to watch over here. Now we are closing DL2 at the end. Now let me show the output for this. So we'll be getting DNA and the definition of it, RNA and the definition of the same. So here you can check, here we have given DNA in small letter and here it is coming in capital letter, because here in DT we used the text transform as uppercase. So this is one of the attribute which is used to change the case, whether it is uppercase, lowercase or whatever. And we are giving the color as red, font size all those things we are setting over here for DT and DD as it is a CSS property. Okay, so this is about description list. So by here our types of list is getting over. Next we are going to learn about inserting images. So inserting images in our website, in our web page, how are we going to do that? Images are used to make your website more attractive, to more to beautify your web page and to impress your audience too. Okay, so images can also be used as a navigation tool to help users browse through the web page. Suppose if the user is clicking on particular image, you'll be taken to some other web page. Okay, so that is called navigation tool. Using your image, you are navigating the user from one web page to other web page or one website to other website. So web browsers support various graphics formats such as GIF, JPEG, whatever types are available. Everything can be accepted by any kind of browser. Okay. Next, we are going to see about types of images. So what are the types of images are available? Inline image and the other one is external image. Inline image is nothing but that kind of images will be displayed automatically along with your website. So whenever your website is loading, your image also will get loaded and you can able to see your image in the site itself. Okay, so here to insert inline images, we are going to use image tag, img tag. External image is nothing but images will not be displayed on your screen. Only when you are clicking on a particular link, you will be taken to that particular image. Okay, so for example, like suppose if your friend is sending any wishes, okay, kind of wishes in WhatsApp, you'll be getting a link stating that so and so is sending wishes for you, Diwali wishes or Pongal wishes or whatever, okay, wishes to you. To see that, you just click on this link. So if you click on that, you'll be taken to that particular website or web page and that particular greetings will be shown, that image will be shown on the screen. Okay, so that is what external image, that cannot be, that will not be displayed in your particular website directly. One day when you are clicking on some link, you will be able to see that particular image. Okay, so that is external image. And here anchor tag, a tag, is used for used to insert your external image. So to insert inline image, we are going to use img tag. To insert external image, we are going to use anchor tag. What is this img tag, image tag? So image tag is used to add image in the HTML web page directly. It is an empty tag and requires different attributes to be specified along with it. As we are going to insert image, so we should have images in a specific place in our web page. So where to insert that particular image, whether it is left aligned or right aligned or center aligned or top, bottom or center, middle of your web page, and even the height and width of your picture, the size of your picture, everything should be mentioned clearly in your image tag. So those are the attributes of your img tag. Next, I'm going to show how to define these images in your website or web page. So defining the source of the image. So usually we'll be having our pictures in a particular folder or sometimes in a desktop or sometimes in some other page, okay, some other folder. Okay, so how to define those images? Okay, so here src is an attribute which is used to add and describe the source of the image in your web page. So here syntax of this src is image, src is equal to, within double quotation we have to mention the path of the image file or address of the image file. Okay, so let me show how to insert these path or address of your image file. So even for this we have three different types to insert an image file. For that src attributes, we have three different styles. First one, suppose if our image is present in the same folder where your HTML program is available, you can directly use the name of the picture. Okay, suppose if the name of the picture is pic, epic.jpg within double quotation. Okay, so here in this case your image and the HTML program should be available within the same folder. Okay, so in that case you can use this source code. Next, in case if your image is in another folder, you have to use the path of your picture. Okay, so how to identify the path of your picture? IMG SRC is equal to, with a double quotation, we have to mention the address or path of your image. How to do that? So let me go to a folder which has this, which has some image, and I'll show you how to add these, how to find this path. Okay, so now we are having all these images here. Now I'm just going to find the path of this particular image. So now just right click on it. From this list, select open with. From the list which you are getting, you can select any browser, whether it is a Firefox or Chrome or Internet Explorer, whichever browser is available, you can select that. So I'm just clicking on Firefox. So our image is getting opened. Yes, okay. So now this AIM image got opened in my browser. Okay, now you can see over here. So this is called the path of the image, where it is showing file, C drive, users, name of your device, desktop, and the name of the folder and name of your image. Okay, so this is called your path. So now just select it, right click, you can use copy option, or you can directly select Control C also, and you have to come over to your program and you have to paste it. So this is how you can find your path of the image. Okay, so now let me go back to our content. Next, the third type is image in web server. Suppose if your image is available in some other website, open that and open that website and select the path as I shown in the previous example, how you have selected, how you are copied your path from your browser. In the same way, you have to do it even for the images in the web browser. So these are the three ways of inserting images from different source of your images. Okay, so next we are going to see about specifying height and width for the image. This is another attribute of your image tag. So the height attribute specifies the height which is in pixel of an image, either in the form of an integer, or you can give even in the form of a percentage. Okay, and even for width, that will be specified as a pixel only, in both the ways, integer and percentage value. So example is IMG SRC is equal to, within double quotation, we have to mention the name of the pic or path. Okay, then style is attribute is equal to height and width. We should mention here, like with a colon, height colon, I'm giving in percentage, then semicolon, then I'm giving the width of the pic. Okay, so this is how we have to mention the height and width of your image. So next we are going to see about aligning the image. How to align your image? To align the image, we are going to use the float CSS property, and here using this align image, you can align only your text either in the left or right side. You cannot align it in the center. So again, IMG SRC is equal to name of the pic and style float colon right or left. You have to mention the alignment. Then width and height, here I've given this within pixel. In the previous example, I gave it in percentage, here I'm giving in pixel px. Okay, so this is aligning the image. The next we are going to see about alt attribute. The third attribute is alt attribute. Sometimes when you are having some network issue, lack of internet connection, or maybe some other reason like slow network connection, or you don't have space, enough space to load that particular picture in your device, you'll be seeing the name of the pic inside the picture box. Okay, so that is called alt attribute. Instead of showing the image, we are going to show only the name of the pic. Okay, so that is called alt attribute. So let me show the example for that particular alt attribute. And in this example, I have included the attributes of all the things which we have seen previously, like SRC attribute, height and width, and even the aligning. Okay, so now I'm going to show you the example. So here, if you take this img, SRC is equal to name of the pic, then alt attribute, alt text message, image of computer saying, suppose due to network connection or due to the lack of space in the user's device, if they are not able to download that particular image in their device, they'll be seeing this text. So this is alternate text, alternate to the image. So that's why this is called as alt image, alternate of the image. And style, float, right alignment, width and height I'm giving in pixel. Okay, so that's it. So let me show the output for this. Yes, so here as I'm giving this float style as right side, so I'm getting the image at the right side. Okay, here everything is perfect, so I'm just getting the image as it is. Now the next example will be having the alt text. Okay, because while loading this particular page, I just switched off my internet connection and I loaded this same program, but here we are seeing only the text, alternate text, image of computer science, whichever we have given in a program will be shown here. So this is the use of alternate image, alternate text. Okay, so next we are going to see about how to insert images in a table cell. You can insert images in a table cell. Suppose if you are inserting a table and each and every cell inside the table will have some particular images. So in that case, you can use this. But before that, we should learn what is table, how to add cells inside the table, all these things, how to insert table in our website, how to set the alignment, what are the properties are available for that particular table. All these things we have to learn before this. Only then you can understand this concept. So in the next video, I'll be explaining about tables. And then I'll be adding an example of this particular images in a table cell in my next video. Okay. Thank you all. Happy learning.